to avoid being mistaken when we're seeking pleasure of life. One day in the forest of walking, a youth both handsome and wise, and as he was walking, he witnessed an event was unusual and strange. A lake was there in the forest, with a crowd of people around. As he watched, they jumped into the water and splashed around searching within. They came out all wet and dirty and dived in again and again. A hero then asked the bystander, "Will you please explain to me now? What are all these people all doing? Please tell me what happened here." "Well now," replied the bystander, "you should know that we all love our king. And the king has a beautiful daughter, and he loves her so dearly as well. He gave her a present, a necklace of beautiful diamonds and pearls. But one day the necklace just vanished, and nobody knows where it went. Now somebody saw that necklace in the lake in the forest just here. And that's why these people have gathered to try to gain the reward." "I see," replied our young hero. And he waited and watched what went on. When dusk came, all returned to their homes. All, that's to say, except him. He stayed there and in the end slept there. In the morning, he woke and got up. The first sun rays beamed, the birds sang, and the light, like a mirror, was still. A hero then looked in the lake and yes, the necklace he found. But when he looked closely, he realized it was just a reflection, no more. Very soon he spied the real necklace in a magpie's nest high in the tree. He climbed up, he took it, descended, and quickly ran off to the king. But the king was exceedingly grateful. "Oh, now what can I give you?" he asked. Just then, who came in but his daughter? Very soon, the wedding took place, and as far as I know, to this moment, they're living together in bliss. Now, the lesson to learn from this story, the happiness we're seeking now, in this world of dull, inert matter, is just a reflection. No more. To be happy, we have to be conscious. And consciousness is of the soul. But we've forgotten our original nature. We think with its body and mind. Inert matter is dead and unconscious. It can't give joy to the soul. Dull matter is lower, mind higher, and the soul is highest. Spiritual practice is needed. Bit by bit, the soul will awake. We will realize our original nature, eternal happiness,